Ladies and gentlemen, from all the way from Nashville, is Kendra Lancaster.
Yeah!
Yeah, right? Got it? Alright, cool. I am so fucking overdressed, but I don't care. I feel like a million bucks right now. I don't even care. I got a haircut for you people. Woo! Fucking appreciate it. Woo! Holy shit, guys. I thought I was going to have my life so much more together right now. Instead, I'm standing here in Tim's Cajun kitchen. I'm sorry, I zoned out for a minute. I got too bleak. Okay. I found the great pubic hair, you guys. I'm totally kidding. I don't have pubic hair. I'm totally I have zero body hair at all, anywhere on my body. So, no, it's like, I know you guys, like, when I walked up here, they're like, what's 1950s librarian, bitch? I know how I look, okay? I know. Actually, I did work in a library for a long time. People would be like, oh, sexy librarian. I'm like, no, actually, you need a master's degree to be a librarian. They'd be like, you killed my boner, stop talking. I worked at the MTSU Library, Middle Tennessee State University.
Yeah.
I forgot that I'm not in Tennessee anymore. So I guess I should say that. MTSU slogan should be like, MTSU, we take anybody. Because I think my favorite story from the library is when I was there, I had a girl come up to me, and she was asking me about a book. It was a library, right place. So at least she got that down. And I wrote down a call number, and I was like, here you go. And she goes, what's this? And I know that's like, no, that I got that every day. That didn't bug me. I was like, it's a call number. And I explained to her what it is. I was like, you go. And I, all right, I'm in Alabama. Let me explain. A call number. it's a number. Like, it's a couple numbers, and then that's where on the spine of the book. The spine of the book is the hard part. Book. Do I need to define book? Do I need
yes.
So she's going, and she goes, she looks at the call number, looks back at me, looks back at the call number, looks back at me, and goes, well, I've never been to this library before. Like, we're the first library to use the Dewey Decimal System. And I was like, she only uses Library of Congress. That's what it is. Anybody smoke weed in here?
Yeah.
Never smoked weed in my life. Aww, never in my entire life. I am too goody two shoes. I had a friend of mine tell me that he smoked a rose petal joint, and it made him really horny. And I tried to roll a rose petal joint, and my mom walked in and went, "You're doing it wrong, you idiot." And my mom was a big druggie, and she was like, "I'm not even good at rolling joints. Like, what the hell? Like, you're still doing it." I was like, "I'm sorry, I don't have the experience." But at the same time, she's very excited that I've never done drugs. But I think also I could see the disappointment, just a little bit. Guys, I just got over mono.
Woo!
I went to the doctor and they were like, "Hey, there's a certain age cutoff where you really can't get it anymore, and you almost made it, but you didn't." And I work with middle schoolers, and I'm like, "That's how I had to have got it." And the middle schooler I made out with wasn't even that hot. So so annoying. Oh, but no, like every time I get sick. I think it's AIDS. I don't know why. it's AIDS, but it's AIDS. It's never cancer, it's AIDS, and that's it. So in college, to my surprise, I got my very first yeast infection. To which I thought that was AIDS, until I figured out what it was. So I'm in Murfreesboro, Tennessee, because I go to MTSU, we take anybody, in case you forgot. So I'm at the Walmart at the pharmacy, and the lady behind the counter goes, "Oh, wait, I guess I shouldn't mention before that, sexy pharmacist." I was like, holy shit, super hot dude. And I'm standing there, and she was like, are you allergic to anything? And I was like, yeah, I'm allergic to sulfa. And she goes, hold on a second. Walks towards Sexy Pharmacist. He's a pharmacist, guys. He knows what that pill was for. Anything that could have happened with him died right there. He's like, I'm sorry. I don't want your bread-baking vagina right now. I'm so upset. Oh, my God. It killed me. So, since the yeast infection, though, I've been trying to sleep naked. Don't picture it, even though I know you are. I'm sleeping naked because, like, I've heard it's really good for you. I don't know why. Like, you know, you're also supposed to go around barefoot, but again, Alabama, I know you guys go around barefoot. So, yeah, like, it really helps to, like, let my HPV breathe, you know. So, it looks like a cluster of grapes down there, but, like, I try just, like, breathe. That was so stupid. So you guys on social media?
Woo!
I heard that my kids told me, they were like, we've stopped using social media because old people like you use it. What? What? I mean, you're not wrong, but what? And, because it's like, you know when your mom got a Facebook and you're like, okay. So that's how they feel right now. They're 12. And so they're like, you're 23, you're ancient. And I'm like, okay. So anyway, social media. The thing is I tend to add acquaintances on social media, and I shouldn't do that. Because I think I offend people very easily. But there was this one girl who went to Japan, and she was taking pictures of everything. It was like, this is my house, this is my family, this is my car, this is my blah, blah, blah. And it was blowing up all my feed on Instagram, Facebook, whatever else. I don't give a shit. Whatever else. And she kept taking pictures of the family dog. And I was like, it's so annoying when you post pictures of your food, right? Like, I get it. Like, before and after. We got it. Anybody watch TV?
Yay!
Okay. I love The Price is Right. I love it. It's like my favorite show, because I guess I'm an 80-year-old woman on the inside. But like, when I was a kid, I remember I would only get excited about cars and trips. I'd be like, oh, a kitchen set? Who gives a fuck? Like, you know? And now I know I'm getting older because I'm like, oh my God, the carpet comes with the bedroom set. Mom, the carpet comes with the bedroom. Like, I would kill if someone gave me a bedroom set. But some of those people, like, oh, they are so old. And I'm expecting them to be like, and it's a brand new coffin. And like, because that, I feel like, is the only practical thing that these people could ever need. And is anybody else waiting for somebody to get sucked under the wheel and spin off the top? Anybody else?
Yeah.
Fingers crossed. One day. Oh my God, I'm too fat to cross my fingers. Like, that is the saddest shit ever. I just had to do it like, okay, does anybody else? Okay, my other favorite show that I love is Hoarders. Oh my God, I wish they would bring that show back so bad. It made me feel so much better about myself, and then it also made me want to clean. Like, whenever I get done, I'd be like, oh, I gotta get all this shit out of here. My favorite episode by far was a woman who had 36 cats, 19 of which were dead. And I'm talking here just scooping through the trash. Another cat corpse, oops. What? What? She was like, oh, I forgot that, you know, I can't think of a southern cat name. I don't know. Oh, I said Mr. Cooter earlier. I forgot that Mr. Cooter had 17 kittens and then I just let them all die. What? So this woman got like, I'm amazed she didn't get arrested for animal abuse because it pisses me off when people are mean to animals. They're helpless and they can't do anything. And I mean, I hate cats, but I don't care. That's just, oh, anyway, that's a different story for a different time. But I looked over at my boyfriend and I went, can you believe that? 19 dead cats. And he goes, well, I can say that. I have 19 dead cats. And I was like, what the fuck are you talking about? I was like, because I murdered that much pussy. Oh my God, guys, I'm totally kidding. I don't have a boyfriend. I'm so lonely. No, I did. did have a boyfriend. We broke up. He was just getting sick of all the blowjobs. He was just getting so sick of it. Like, he'd wake up and I'd give him a blowjob, and like, before he went to bed, like, I'd wake him up in the middle of the night. I would, you know, like, while he was watching a game, I'd give him a blowjob. Like, if, you know, I'd come to his work and I'd give him a blowjob. He was just getting so So, like, if you guys, like, you know, don't mind that, if you want to give me your phone number, then it's okay. But I know that it's a hassle. Like, I get it. No, now I'm dating again. Kind of don't know how anymore. Oh! Fucking guys are trying to take me on dates to the park! What is this? To the park? What is this bullshit? Do you think I wake up like this? That I look like this? And then I'm fat and overweight. I'm not gonna walk and sweat all of this off so you see what I really look like. Fuck me. And then you can see what I really look like with all the makeup sweated off. That's the only exercise that I will do, okay? Jesus Christ. You're too cheap to buy me a coffee. I don't even like coffee, but you know what? I would appreciate the gesture. Oh, it makes me so angry. Like, that's how fucking cheap you are. That, and they always ask for weird times to meet me at the park. And I'm like, you're totally gonna murder me. No, that's not gonna happen. What I've noticed is guys, and I guess girls too. I don't know, I've never done anything with a girl, so I'm not gonna judge. But people jump too quickly into sex. And like, does anybody here miss a good old dry hump? Is that just me? Like, I totally, I miss it so much. Like, it reminds me of middle school. The arm of my couch was my bitch, okay? I that thing. I don't know if guys can relate. I guess in between the couch cushions, was that what it was? Was that what it was? So, I was at Spencer's, because I guess not only am I an old woman, I'm a 12-year-old boy. I was at Spencer's, and I saw this little, like, slutty uniform that I couldn't even fit, like, a nipple in that said, BJU. And I was like, Blowjob University, oh, I get it. And then I was like, my parents were so proud when I graduated from the prestigious BJU, Blowjob University. There was a rigorous written and oral exam. Yeah, I graduated summa cum laude. And you know who the speaker was? It was Benedict Cumberbatch. That was me. I was telling my friend in Nashville, DJ, I don't know if you guys know Mr. DJ Buckley. He is the greatest. And I was like, DJ, all my jokes are about blowjobs. And he was like, write about what you know. That's so sad. And after he said that to me, he was like, yeah, it occurred to me that truth is the second hardest thing to swallow.